Restriction enzymes are endonucleases that allow you to cut DNA at specific sites. This allows you to generate ends that can be easily ligated into a vector such as a plasmid. There are a lot of restriction enzymes out there. Around 3,000 have been discovered. So how do you pick the right one? To figure this out, you'll need the sequence of your target and the sequence of the vector you'd like to put it into. And, of course, a reference list of the enzymes available to you. The ideal enzyme or pair of enzymes will cut just outside your target. You want to make sure that you'll get all of the target sequence without much overhang. You'll also need to ensure that the cut sites are arranged in the proper orientation. If they don't line up with the plasmid correctly, you could express the antisense version of your gene or mess up any fusions you're trying to create. Once you have your enzymes picked out, you can assemble your reaction. The exact volumes of each reagent will vary based on concentrations and manufacturer recommendations, but the typical digest contains template DNA, recipient plasmid, your enzyme or pair of enzymes, the buffer recommended by the manufacturer, and nuclease-free water. If you're only using one enzyme, you might need to use a phosphatase to make sure your recipient plasmid doesn't turn right back into a circle. The reaction conditions will also vary based on your enzymes. Be sure to check the protocols for temperature and time. Sometimes digestions take an hour, but other times they could be as long as overnight. After the digestion, you're ready to run a gel to separate the insert and vector, and then conduct a ligation to fuse them together. For tips on running a successful gel and extracting bands, check out our Everything Gels video series. This video is brought to you by EcoR1, an enzyme capable of digesting DNA in 15 minutes or less.